Hello, aquapreneurs. I am Joe Quirk. I am an author and I am a seasteader. Seasteading is homesteading the high seas, the technology for politically independent cities that float on the ocean is at hand, and I am here to bring you peace. Seasteaders want voluntary societies based on choice, not force. Barack Obama defined government as, quote, "A monopoly on violence," unquote. The problem with state politics is that all our political opinions represent threats against people who disagree with us. It's very difficult for a monopoly on violence to form if people can detach and sail their homes elsewhere. Power corrupts people, land is the locus of power, and this is the technology for the decentralization of power. If you can vote with your house, we'll have a market of governance, not a monopoly of government. These are the fluid mechanics of voluntary societies that can't be properly characterized as states. You're looking at our modular, expandable floating city project, which we plan to build soon and sustainably, and the technology for floating eco-villages is already in place. South Korea inaugurated three floating islands modeled after flowers, all powered by the sun. They have a convention hall, restaurants, and arcades, all solar powered. How do we do this on the deep sea with high waves? Robert Ballard, who discovered the Titanic, proposed the flip structure for seasteads. It's so heavy at the bottom, it's described as being as stable as a fence post in 70-foot waves. You take four flips, you put a platform across it, it's as stable as a table. Ballard says you build floors above, you build floors below, you have an aquarium in your bedroom. The concept has already been demonstrated with oil platforms, which are built to withstand hurricanes. In a tsunami, you're safer at sea than on a coastal city. Is this only for badass oil rig workers, or is it safe for little old ladies? An 86-year-old woman has been living on the sea since 2007. Lee Watchsetter lives on the Crystal Serenity. Her mobile city has brought her to 100 countries. Imagine waking up every day with a different country at your doorstep. I was on an Alaskan cruise, and it's like going camping and taking your mall with you. When I was inside bowling, I couldn't tell that I was on the ocean. Cruise ships are floating skyscrapers. They flourish where there is no state. They dock in one nation, fly the flag of another nation, incorporate in another nation, hire from anywhere. They pick and choose the laws best suited to their industry, and they make billions. Passengers sign a contract for onboard healthcare with these floating cities that bring their private hospitals along with them. Carnival Cruises whimsically announced itself as a new floating nation in 2012. I was on a cruise ship where all the water was desalinated seawater. But what about the waves? You'll get seasick. To the left, we see mini golf. I define civilization as the place where grandpa can putt. I sat on the deck of a cruise ship, ordered a martini, and they could pour it right to the rim and it wouldn't spill. That week was the best standard of living I've ever had. Our primitive nation-states can't compare to civilization. We don't have to argue about politicians on a cruise ship. And yet the captain doesn't send SWAT team raids to our cabin, he sends butlers. What drives improvement in a market of governance is the power to jump ship and choose a better offer. Seasteading is not a plan for a political system, but a technology for anybody to start their own political system. We plan to provide the platforms for people to create as many startup societies as possible. If customers can choose among them, and seasteads compete to attract them, we'll have a proliferation of societies who have to attract residents or dissolve. No politicians needed. If you have a superior plan for other people's lives, let's see it compete on the aquatic marketplace. Good ideas don't require force. Stop arguing, start seasteading. The greatest ocean polluters are land-based eaters and poopers. Agriculture and sewage account for 80% of marine pollution. Our Dutch engineers plan to use algae to absorb coastal runoff and turn it into food and fuel. Seasteaders plan to clean your coasts at a profit. Despite this popular movie, no pirate has ever boarded a ship with a security team on board, and 75% of cargo ships have security teams. If cargo ships felt threatened by pirates, they wouldn't defend themselves with squirt guns. But who will build the roads? Venice is an architectural masterpiece built on stilts that the ancients described as the floating city. Recently, 89% of the people of Venice voted to secede, and Italy said no. What if these individual units could break up, float away, reform as they please? You'd have new societies disassembling and reassembling all over the seas, adapting fluidly to the desires of people choosing. If Venetians can build a wealthy republic more than 1,000 years ago with muscle power and firewood, we can build floating cities with diesel and hydraulics. We do not live on planet Earth. We live on planet Ocean. The ocean's surface is more than twice the size of planet Earth. That green spot up top is Hawaii. The physics of this frontier means that monopolies of violence emerge on land while voluntary seasteads emerge on water. If you want to learn about how seasteaders plan to feed the world, restore the environment, enrich the poor, and liberate humanity from politicians, go to seasteading.org, tell us what you want to see in your floating city, and in 2020, I plan to see you on the blue frontier. I'll see you there, aquapreneurs.